is Merlin Seeley with Lisa Van Til's Little Organic Gardening Guides, and today I'm going to be talking to you about organic and homemade all-natural pesticides for your organic garden. Now, what we have right here is your traditional 2-gallon sprayer, and I have filled it almost all the way to the top with just clean, regular water. Now, before we get into making this here pesticide homemade, I'm going to talk about a couple of all-natural pesticides that you can do yourself in your organic garden with not a lot of work. A couple of plants bugs don't like, worms don't like. One of those happen to be marigolds, also known as stinkweed for various reasons. If you plant marigolds throughout your garden, this is an organic, all-natural pesticide because, like I said, they prefer to stay away from this plant, and the more you have them into your garden, the more that they'll be beneficial to taking care of your pests. Another thing you can plant is lemon balm, thyme. These are actual plants that are pesticides as well, all natural pesticides. If you can get your hands on a tincture or a oil of lemon balm or oil and tincture of thyme, you could actually mix it with your water, or you could put it directly into your garden, into the soil and on the plant leaves and stuff like that. And this is an all-natural pesticide as well. The pests don't like the thyme smell, the taste, or the lemon balm. Now, what we're going to make here is the one that I use all the time in my organic garden. And this is just simply mixing just a certain ingredients together and spraying into your garden, and you have yourself an all-homemade pesticide. What we got here, it's just a traditional biodegradable, all-natural, plant-derived liquid detergent. It doesn't matter what brand you use. Just make sure that it's 100% biodegradable, all-natural, plant-derived, which means it will not hurt the environment, the soil, or your plants. And what we're going to do is just mix about 4 teaspoons, which would be about 4 tablespoons of this biodegradable soap. And it's just ordinary dish soap. The bugs can't stand the taste of soap, believe it or not, on your plants. Now, you're also going to take your favorite hot sauce. It doesn't matter what brand you use. And we're going to take this hot sauce, and we're going to put quite a bit into the water as well. Now, it's hard to get out, but normally you'd want to put about 4 teaspoons, 2 tablespoons of this hot sauce as well. So if I put about 3/4 of the bottle in here, it's going to equal about 4 tablespoons. All right, that's a good bit. The bugs can't stand the taste of hot sauce just as much as they can't stand the taste of soap. Now you're going to want to mix this up. Put too much in here, you're going to clog up your sprayer. If that happens, you're going to have to clean it out, and then you're going to find another way of getting the rest of it out of there. Now come with me as we go to the garden. I'll show you the proper way to spray your plants. Here we are in the organic garden, and I'm going to show you how to use your homemade pesticide properly on your plants. When you spray in your plants, you want to make sure that you get the underside of the leaves as well as top side of the leaves and all around the plants as well. That's because the bugs will actually hide underneath the leaves, so you want to try and get underneath your leaves as well. And you want to spray all of your garden and let this dry on your leaves or your plants, and once you do that, your pest will not want anything to do with the plants. And it's just that simple for a homemade or organic pesticide in your garden that is eco-friendly as well as friendly for your plants. This has been Merlin Seeley with Lisa Van Til's Little Organic Gardening Guides. Thanks for watching.